Hello, Simmers. It's Pursi here today. I'm so excited to play more Sims 4 with you. So sit back, relax, and grab a snack. I'm not sponsored or anything, but I personally recommend that you grab a bag of Flamin' Hot Puffs or Funyuns and send your taste buds on a wild ride. All right, guys, let's get into the video.
Happy Mother's Day to all my mothers out there watching. I hope you guys are having a great Mother's Day today. I was unable to see my mom for Mother's Day because we live in separate cities, and so I just had to send her a card for Mother's Day because I really couldn't think of any good Mother's Day gifts for her. My fiance actually sent her roses, so he showed me up this Mother's Day. What did you guys get your moms for Mother's Day? I'm curious. Want to steal some ideas for next year, possibly, because I really couldn't think of anything good for her and reasonable, because I'm not working right now, so I have very limited funds. And she said she really liked the card, but I wish I could have done more for her for Mother's Day. I wanted her to have a good Mother's Day. So hopefully my sisters who live in St. Louis were able to make her Mother's Day lovely and make her feel super loved and appreciated. I really hope so, and I really hope that all you mothers out there were able to feel loved and appreciated today as well. I wanted to do another speed build today. I love building, and I'm always trying to get better at building, so I figured the best way is just practice, practice, practice. And I'm hoping that somebody will jump on one of these videos and just like give me some good advice, some good tips, so that I can grow and get better. Actually, my last speed build, which was also my first speed build, my sister watched it. I told two of my sisters about my channel, and they wanted to see a video, so I sent them the speed build video, and she watched it, and she was so nice and supportive, and she made me feel really good about my build. She was just like, it's worth that much money for a reason. She's like, it's really good, and she's like, it was so interesting watching your process, and she was just like so encouraging, and she was just telling me how good it was. And I know it wasn't that good, but it was still nice to hear her say that. Like, I think she's very biased because she's my sister, but I don't care. I love it, and that made me feel so good. So it, like, really, I was just like, now I gotta do another one. I was like, I don't care if it gets zero views. Like, I just do it. I mean, I'm doing this for fun anyways, not for the views. So that's one part of it, but also just her like encouragement and making me feel like I am a good builder and like I have good potential was just so nice of her. It was sweet. I have good sisters. I'm very lucky. I have four sisters, all younger than me, two brothers younger than me as well. So I have come from a really big family, and so far I've only let two of my sisters know about my channel. I feel like if I let my brother know, the one who's directly under me, I feel like he'd be pretty supportive of it, honestly. I don't know what I'm afraid of. My family likes to joan and flame a lot, so I was just like, I don't have time for you guys to make fun of something that I'm really passionate about yet. I need to build thicker skin, but I'm slowly telling everybody about it, and I feel pretty happy about it. I'm having a lot of fun, and so, you know, eventually I'll just be able to tell everybody, yeah, I'm making YouTube videos for fun. It's a hobby. I love it. And so, you know what? Next step will be to tell my brother. And two of my siblings are actually in elementary school. I'm 24. The youngest is 5. And then the second youngest is 7. And so yesterday I went to I went around and I just bought them a bunch of like goodies and got them a book each and just a bunch of stuff to put in like a little care package. And I'm going to ship it off to them tomorrow. And I'm so excited to see their response. I hope they like what they got, and I hope they can have fun with it. And so I'm super excited to see their reactions to that. So that'll be fun. I love buying gifts for people, and I love shipping things to people. It's so much fun. And I kept it simple because my little sister's birthday is in July, so I'll have to actually send her something worthwhile in July. And like I said, I'm not working right now, so funds are limited, so I had to keep it simple, keep it small. So that'll be fun. And I don't know if I'll be able to go actually see her for her birthday this year. I go down to St. Louis every year for her birthday, no matter what. Even one year I was fighting with my mom. We got into a huge argument, but I still was like, I'm coming down to see Kamaya for her birthday. And I went, and it'll be pretty hard for both of us, I think, if I'm not able to go see her for this birthday. It'll suck, but yeah, that's okay. Well, I guess enough about me and my oh, wait, one more thing. I got new headphones and a new mic, and I'm so excited, and I hope the audio is much better with this. This is my first time recording with the new mic and headphones, so fingers crossed that when I upload this video, the audio is good. I'm super pumped. I like them so far, so I really hope that they were worth the money and I don't have to return them and find new headphones all over again, 'cause I don't want to wait. And I really want my videos to be good. Like, I put in a lot of work and time into these videos, and it may just be like a hobby and for fun, but I put in a lot of time and effort to them, and I really want them to be good, and I want people to be able to like enjoy them. I don't want them to be like, I wish I could watch this, but ugh, this audio is cringing like my ears, it hurts. So I really hope that this turns out really well. Yeah, but okay, yeah, now enough about my personal stuff. We can talk about the build a little bit. We've been in a video for like 6 minutes, and I've not mentioned the build at all. I think I named this like traditional family home or something like that. When it comes to like styles of home and architectural styles, I have very little knowledge about it. So I don't know, is this considered a is this a craftsman? Is it a Cape Cod? I don't think it's a Cape Cod. It might be a craftsman. I don't know. So just to avoid that, I just call it like traditional family home. And like that's what it's called. So like I'm gonna upload it to the gallery if you guys want it. So that's what it's gonna be called or something like that. And yeah, I don't know what architectural style this is, but I just really the whole idea behind this house was I wanted to make stairs like that, like the oh, L-shaped staircase, is that what it is? I don't know. I just wanted to do that, and I wanted to have it wrapped around this pillar going up 3 flights of stairs. Like, that was my whole vision for this build. I didn't even have an architectural design in mind. I just wanted to do that with the stairs. And then the house, this just became the style of the house and the structure of it. And yeah. And I wasn't sure if I should go with that, with those green panels and the brick, because it's starting to look very Christmassy. But you know what? I stuck with it. I really like the green. Maybe I should have went with like a brownish stone instead of the red brick. But I went with the red brick, and I actually really like it. I really like this house. I know it's just basically a big box, but I think it's so cute. And I cut out a lot of the outside because I kept like fiddling around with it, trying to make it more interesting on the outside. So a lot of stuff. You guys don't get to watch because I didn't even record it. I just went about trying to make it more interesting because I was like, I'm gonna have to cut out a lot anyways because I take forever to build and I don't want it to be super long. So I didn't record it. So, but at the end when we do like our tour, not really a tour because I like just like speed through the house like a maniac because I don't know how to control the camera very well. You get a slight glimpse of like what the final outside of the house was like, and like you get to see some of the landscaping, but not all the landscaping, because again, I was just like trying to make it more interesting, and I was just like, I've recorded enough of the outside, and so I decided not to, and all of that, so it's fine. One thing that I need to work on is I do that a lot when I'm talking. It's just such a natural habit, and I every time I hear myself do it, I'm just like, ah, stop, don't do that while you're recording. And it's so hard, and now that I've mentioned it, I'm consciously trying not to do it, but it physically is hurting me. Like, my soul is just like, I'm not me if I can't do that. But that's gotta be annoying, right? To watch this video and hear somebody go all the time. So I'm gonna try and stop it. Like, especially if you're wearing headphones, I imagine that sound. And some people are like really iffy about like sounds, and I feel like that would make them like cringe, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to hurt other people with my weird mannerisms, so I'm gonna try to actively not do that, but it won't be easy for me, honestly, truly. Yeah, and I And I cut out a lot on the inside too. I didn't want this video to be too long. Honestly, I should have cut out more because it's still super long. But I don't want to cut out too much because when I watch speed builds, I get so frustrated when the builders cut out so much stuff. I'm like, I want to see it all. I don't care if it's a 2 hour long build. I don't care if it's speed build real time. Like, I don't care. I want to see every painstaking detail, please. But they're way more well established, and so I don't, yeah, so I don't, I won't do that, even though I get frustrated with, because I'm just like, I'm just doing this for fun, and I don't think anybody's gonna click on this if it's 2 hours, 3 hours long. I would, but I feel like I'm in the minority on that. I feel like most people don't like super long YouTube videos, and I do, which is crazy because the most I don't watch a lot of movies because they're so. I'm just like, I don't want to sit here for 2 hours watching the same thing. But if it's Sims content, I'm like, I will sit here for hours. That's why I love live streams so much, because I'm just like, oh, I just get to sit here and watch somebody play The Sims for hours on end, and it's amazing, and I love every waking moment of it. And going back and watching live streams, stuff like that, I'm just like, oh, this is great. I love it. So yeah, but that's not me. That's not my life. I'm not posting super long videos as of right now. Maybe later in the future, if somebody's interested, then maybe. But as of right now, as far as I'm concerned, no one's interested in seeing that from me. No, you got, I mean, so I'm not gonna do it. It's fine. And so yeah, we're doing the kitchen, and I just wanted to do like just a little table as like a island. Instead of putting in an actual island, I thought an actual island would make it seem kind of crowded in this little corner. So I just put that little table, and I really like that. I like doing that. I think it's cute to have like sometimes just a table be the island, and then it still were, and then like still had like two chairs there, so like it's still like a little breakfast bar. And I love the color of those chairs. I decided that whoever lives in this house really loves like greens and blues, and so there's a lot of greens and blues in the south, especially green. I think at one point I may have went a little green crazy, but that's okay. That's a color I don't use a lot, which is when I was little, when I was like kindergarten and younger, my favorite color was green, and it was so much my favorite color that I wanted to be the green Power Ranger. Like, most of my girl cousins wanted to be pink. Nobody wants to be yellow, poor yellow. I don't know why, but they all want to be pink. And meanwhile, I'm like, I'm green, I'm green. And I remember I got into an argument with, I don't know, it was either my brother or my cousin. And they were like, you can't be green, you're a girl. And I was just like, excuse you, yes, I can, because green's my favorite color. And I'm finna be stupid pink. And I was very upset about it. And I was angry. And I put my foot down as a little 5-year-old kindergartner, like, I want to be green. And I was green, and you know what, no one can tell me otherwise. And so I don't know when I stopped liking green, but I was obsessed with that color as a child. And yeah, so I guess my inner child is just like, oh, let's have some nostalgia and do green, green, green. Now I'm all about purple. Purple's my favorite color in the whole world. I love it. Probably a little too much, but that's okay. That started in middle school. In middle school, I was just like, yeah, purple's, purple's, that's it, that's for me. And it stuck around, and I think that might be, I think I'm almost 25, so I think that might be now my favorite color forever. So like, I started off with green, and then I was just like, oh, sky blue and turquoise and those like colors like that. And then middle school came, and I was like, purple. Purple's my favorite color, and it's stuck, and I think it's here to stay. So yeah, that's my favorite color. So if I do a lot of things in purple, it's because it's my favorite color. What's your guys' favorite color? I'm curious. Do you even have one? Some people don't. Lafay My fiance Toffee, which I call him Toffee, it's not his real name, it's his nickname. He doesn't have a favorite color really, and so like really, we just buy them a lot of things that are like green and blue. And for the longest time, I was like, isn't your favorite color like green and blue? And he was like, no. And I was just like, but you have so much stuff that are that color. And he goes, no, you guys buy me stuff in those colors. And so I'm just stuck with it. And I was just like, oh. Like, his parents would do it. So I was just like, oh, okay, his parents must know that his favorite colors are green and blue, particularly green. He has a lot of green stuff. So I was like, okay, I'll just keep doing that. And I guess he's right. I guess I never really got confirmation that was his favorite color. And you know what? To this day, still buy him a lot of things in those colors. Cause like, I don't know what else, like, what other colors does he want? Pick a color. Pick at least a palette, a few colors that are your favorite. Make this easier on me, dude. But nope, this is not his style, his forte. So whatever. It's fine. Yeah. So now we are in the living room. Once again with this house. It's not super cluttered. It doesn't have a lot of furniture all over the place. I kept it very sparsely decorated because if you guys download this house off the gallery, then that way it is easier for you to personalize it for your Sims if you're gonna play in it. If you're just gonna put it down as for an NPC's house, still the same. Like it's just an NPC, you're not gonna play in it, so it doesn't really need to be like super cluttered in detail, in my opinion. The only time I really clutter and detail a house is if I'm building it for my Sims that I'm playing with, because I know like their specific tastes and everything that they need and stuff like that. And so that's like the only time I do it. Like if I do, yeah, like a legacy, if I'm doing a legacy family, like my legacy family's house is super decorated, especially with a lot of like family photos and stuff like that, and really cluttered with all their stuff around. So that's like the only time I do it. I cut out all the bathrooms. I didn't let you guys watch even one bathroom in this build because I didn't have enough time. Oh, yep, green. The dining room is very green. I love the idea of that green tablecloth with those very green chairs. I was like, oh, I love this. I never use either of those items ever because it's not my taste personally. So I never use it. But for this house, I was just like, yeah, this is perfect. They're gonna love this. Whoever lives in this house and loves green and blue, they're gonna love this dining room. And yeah, I'm not sure if your Sims can use that glass table that's pushed up against the wall, but I wanted there to be like a clear walkway from that archway, so I like kind of shoved it in there. You can just delete the chair and push it against the wall, or you can just move the table out. It's not, a huge deal if you want this house. You may not want it, so you may not care, which fair enough. And yeah, again, the dining room was like very little furniture. I didn't put a lot of stuff in there, and it's not that big of a dining room. And maybe if I put a smaller table, it might have had more room for more decorations. But it's not that big. So, and I chose that really large table, so there really wasn't a lot of room for a lot of stuff. But also, I probably wouldn't have furnished it a lot anyways. So, if we're being honest with ourselves. And for some reason, picking rugs in this house was so hard for me. I was just like, I don't know what rugs to put where, anywhere, how or why. So, yeah. Yeah. So, I think I use rugs like that a lot in this house, which I never use those rugs because I personally, I don't really like them that much. But they're growing on me, and I'm starting to use them more. I think because I'm sick of using the same ones that I use all the time. So I'm just like trying to branch out because I'm just like, I need more items. I need new items. And I don't download a lot of built CC. So, and I don't think I have any custom cotton rugs. So I'm just stuck with the same old rugs since the beginning of time. And then here is the formal living room, formal lounge room. Again, one with those green chairs from university. Yeah, Discover University. And it's pretty green in here, and it's not a lot of furniture, but again, it's kind of a small room. It's not very big. So it really didn't need a lot of furniture, and the whole point is just to like go in there and like have a conversation, maybe a nice cup of tea or some cups, glasses of wine, whatever, and just enjoy each other's company so that. But really don't need a lot of stuff going on in there, a lot of things to do either. Just have like a little bit of music playing very quietly in the background. That's how I imagined it. And this is where they put their prized possession, which is that really expensive painting. I decided, I was just like, this painting needs to go in this formal living room. And then over here, we're gonna make a little office, very tiny. I imagine one of the parents who live here, this is their office space. They don't allow anybody to go in there. They do a lot of business in here and a lot of working from home, and so it's very off limits to like the kids and guests, and it's just their space, their little private space that they really enjoy, and they don't want other people coming in and messing up the aura in there and touching things and getting them off focus. So yeah, that's how I imagined it. And so just adding some bookcase. I think I put like a little plant in a corner and a painting, and I think that's it. Not a lot of furniture. I gotta stop saying that. I've already said that I don't over like do a lot of clutter, but sometimes I just repeat myself, and that is the honest truth. I do it that a lot, honestly. So yeah, and all of that stuff. And what are we doing now? Well, now we're just doing like the entryway, adding a little bit of stuff in here, a little bit of clutter into the this space, make it look slightly more lived in. Then a little backpack there. Yeah, I always feel like there's not enough clutter items in this game. Like I need more, I need more, I need more. And yeah, I was trying to decide what to put in this little corner here, and I decided to go to a little pets corner because I didn't want like another sitting area. I don't know, it just didn't seem like like we have so many seating areas in this house. I didn't feel like that there needed to be another seating area. I could have maybe expanded the bathroom or did like a little laundry nook right there, but I didn't. I went with the pets area. And the same with this area, I was like, what to do with over here? And then I decided that it's okay to have empty space and have things be very minimum. So that's what I did. Just like that little ottoman and some plants. And then I was looking for something else, but then I was like, no, this is fine. It doesn't need to be super cluttered right here. So I just moved right along, jumping right into the outside area. Again, I try so hard with this outdoor area. It's outdoor areas, backyards are not my strong suit. I am not good at them. But I tried. I know it's not the best. But it's good. It's something. I mean, it's not bad, and it's not like, maybe it is boring, but it's not bad, and so I'm okay with that. It's not bad, and you know what? Right now, that's all I can ask for is for it to be not bad. And so yeah, using that dirt terrain paint to make that gravel look a little hard, like less harsh and less like clear, have clear cut corners like I had it to be had it before. And just fencing off this area a little bit, I decided that whoever lives here, they're like grill people, like real grill people, like they love grills. Like I probably would have put another grill if I didn't think it would be too over the top for a Sims game. But yeah, like you know, like those people who are like really into grilling and they have multiple grills and they would grill on multiple grills at once, and like that's like their hobby, it's their passion. I've met people like that. I'm just like, whoa, the food's really good. But I'm just like, I'd be okay if I never owned a grill in my life. Like, it terrifies me. The thought of grilling food scares me. And I don't even like cooking anyways. So I just don't get it. So I'm just like, wow, you're really intense with this grill lifestyle you got going on, buddy. Can't relate, not even a little bit. But that's all right. And so, yeah, just doing a little bit more landscaping around here. I landscaped on like four different occasions because I was just like, nope, we need more, we need more. And I don't record at all, but I do. Like, I was just like, I was really trying to make the outside interesting. It's so hard. Like, I'm really not a good builder, but I have like come a long way. Like, oh, if you go on my gallery, I think it's Pursi YT, and you scroll all the way down to my first builds, you'll be like, oh wow, oh my, oh honey, no. Because I do, I'm like, oh, but I keep them up there. I'm just like, oh, well, you know, no point in taking it down. And you know what? It just shows my growth and shows that I'm actually like trying very, very hard. So I like to leave them up and I like to go look at them sometimes. I'm just like, oh wow, that was a choice, you know. And that's all right. So yeah, So now I'm just, doing the floor plan. There we go. I knew I could get the words out if I tried. Probably should have just cut out the floor plan. Gave me time to put in other things, but that's all right. And so yeah, just deciding. This house was massive. I cut it out, but that yeah, like I cut out a lot, but that third floor was massive, and I was just like, no, I don't want. So I made it smaller, and I didn't record myself making it smaller, but I made it much smaller because I was just like, oh my gosh, I don't want to furnish this much house. I really didn't. And if I had not made it smaller, oh, this video would be so much longer. I'd probably have it going like 8 times the speed just to get it at a reasonable time frame. And I don't know, that seems like super fast. That seems like it would hurt somebody's head or something, or make them dizzy. And so I don't want to do that to somebody, but I might, one day maybe I'll have to, because I really am a slow builder. And but I like building very large, big houses, but it takes me a very long time. And so like, I don't know, I'd either have to do it in parts, or which I want to avoid doing, or I would have to just speed it up like crazy, or cut out a lot, like either do strictly furnishing or building it, because like doing both would take me way too much time. So yeah, my like allergies are like acting up, like my sinuses are bothering me a lot, and it's like so hard to try and not let it bother me while I'm recording this. We're almost done. Like, I just gotta get through a little bit longer, and then I can go do what I need to do to figure this out. This room is a shared bedroom. I never do shared bedrooms because the thought of sharing a bedroom with a sibling sounds awful. Sorry, guys. I love you so much, but sharing a room with you sounds terrible. I honestly, despite having 6 younger siblings, I never had to share a room with any of them. My mom always made sure that I had my own space, even if it was like basically I was living. At one point, we were in, my room was in a basement, and room is a strong word. It was basically a closet in the basement, and it wasn't even fully finished, and it was not a room. Like I couldn't even fit my dresser in there. I had to put my dresser outside my door because like I could just fit my twin bed in there and like my TV and like a little tiny bucket or something, and it was bad. But I always had my own room. I only had to share a room one point in my life where my mom, my two of my sisters that are in high school, when my mom and their dad were in a relationship and were living together, he had a daughter also the same age as me, and she came to live with us too. And so me and her had to share a room, and it was the worst experience of my life. And I hated it, and I did not like it. And when she moved out to go back with her mom and them, I was just thrilled, and I was so happy to have my room back to myself, and I never had to share a room again, and I was so happy, and I never want to share a room again. Like that was awful. Yeah. And then the other time I had to share a room was like my first year college when I lived in the dorms, and I actually really liked my roommate, but oh my gosh, her and her boyfriend, no, that was a nightmare. That was awful. They used to straight up have they would just have sex like right there. They would just start woohooing even if I was right there. And it was awful, and like I could be on the phone with my mom and they would go at it, and my mom would be like, "What is happening?" And I just have to be like, "I'm sorry, mom. I'm just calling you back." And so I don't like sharing rooms. And I think that that is reasonable. I think I have enough reason to not want to share a room. And so, yeah, sharing a room with Toffee is not bad though. So that's fine. We're doing fine with that. But he pretty much lets me do whatever I want with the bedroom. And he just kind of takes a back seat, and so it's working. Like, it's fine. Like, this experience sharing a bedroom with him isn't bad at all. So, but those other, like, with siblings or like just a random roommate, no, I'm okay. Oh, and I couldn't imagine. Yeah, like I couldn't imagine sharing it with like one sister is very like very anal about organization where things go. So she would probably kill me because I'm very, very messy. So I don't think she would like that. And then the other sister, she sings a lot, and she, I mean, a lot, and it's not. The house is finished. So here's the outside tour. As you can see, I did a lot more things to the outside and more landscaping just to try and make it look more interesting. And then just going through the kitchen and living room, dining room. Gonna head upstairs soon. There's the landing. These are the kids' bedrooms. And upstairs is the master with a nursery. I never do a nursery. I decided to do one this time.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy, please like the video with a big red thumbs up from all the Flamin' Hot Puffs you were eating. Don't be afraid to subscribe. And if you really want to make my day, follow me on Twitter at Percy Not Percy. And no matter what, I hope you have a fan-flippin-tastic day. Bye!